The Philippines and Japan sign a new 30 billion yen or 12 billion peso COVID loan. The finance department says the agreement is the second phase of Japan's COVID-19 crisis response emergency support loan. They add that the Philippines will use this loan to support the country's economic recovery from this pandemic. The first tranche of the deal, worth 50 billion yen or 20.5 billion pesos, was signed by the two countries in July of 2021. Local absentee voting in the Philippines begins today, Wednesday. Data from the COMELEC shows that over 84,000 have signed up for the three-day absentee voting. The LAV is for uniformed personnel and for members of the media who will report to work on Election Day. Ballots for the absentee voting will be canvassed on May 9th. Poll Commissioner George Garcia assures voters that their ballots will be secured. He also assures them not to waste this chance to cast their ballots.
Huwag niyo pong ibaliwalayin itong pagkakataon ito. Ang pakialam natin is dapat makaboto ang lahat ng Pilipino. Ano man ang katayuan niya sa buhay, lalong-lalo na kung siya ay may trabaho.
Crombie's vice presidential bet, Lito Atienza, lambasts the COMELEC after he experienced issues with the agency's online precinct finder. The House Deputy Speaker and three-time Manila Mayor said that he had his staff check his voter status using the website, only to find that his name is missing from the polling precinct in Manila. Now, Atienza believes that this could be an attempt to disenfranchise voters or to cheat in the upcoming polls.
Lumalabas, hindi ako rehistrado ron. Ito po hindi bagong pandaraya. Luma na ito sa kasaysayan ng mga mandarambong sa politika.
Atienza adds that he wants the matter investigated. Another daughter of the Philippine vice president asks the National Bureau of Investigation to trace the creators of malicious online posts against her. A lawyer for Dr. Tricia Robredo wrote to the NBI Cybercrime Division to list all the possible cybercrimes targeting her. Last week, Dr. Robredo's sister, Aika, asked the NBI to probe websites that uploaded fake lewd videos purportedly featuring her. The NBI has already identified some of the administrators who created the malicious posts against Aika. The Bureau says they will ask them to take down these posts. An official of a local volunteer group backing the presidential bid of Vice President Lenny Robredo has gone missing in Quezon Province. Dante Gatlula, the head of the Robredo People's Council in Candelaria, has been gone for 4 days. His family says Gatlula was on his way to Lucena last Saturday to meet with fellow Robredo supporters to discuss the details of a campaign rally scheduled this week. But he never came home and has yet to make contact with anyone. It's still unclear whether Gatlula's disappearance is politically motivated. Police in the Calabarzon region have been notified of Gatlula's disappearance. Less than 2 weeks before the elections, and more areas are placed under the COMELEC's control. The poll body placed Marawi City and 7 other municipalities in Mindanao under their watch upon the recommendations of the police and the military. Marawi was ground zero for the 5-month-long battle between government forces and the ISIS-linked Malta group back in 2017. The towns of Tubaran and Malabang in Danao del Sur were also placed under the COMELEC's control last week. Over 100 other places have meanwhile been identified as areas of concern amid the threat of election-related violence. The Philippine Commission on Elections set strict controls for the planned panel interviews of the presidential and vice presidential bets. The poll body says that the panel members and their questions will first need to be approved by them. COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia says that their partnership with the country's Association of Broadcasters may be finalized by Wednesday. Garcia also responded to doubts raised by VP Betwalden Bello over the poll body's competence in organizing the debates and in the elections in general.
Pag-hold po ng debate ay different matter sa pag-hold ng eleksyon. Wala naman pong may kagustuhan dito sa pangyayaring ito. Siyempre po, ito ay kahit paano dungis, kahit ganong kaliit sa integridad po ng Commission ng Eleksyon. At kami nga po ay humihingi talaga ng paumanhin sa nangyari.
Veteran labor organizer Elmer Labog says that if he wins a seat in the Senate, he will push to increase the nationwide minimum wage. Labog, who is the national chairperson of the Ilusang Mayo Uno, stresses the need for wage hike amid the rising fuel and commodity prices.
It's really revolting that every time there's a crisis and every time we ask for an adjustment, we're always left as the weeping boy of employers. I think it's high time for them to understand that we are in a very difficult situation now. In fact, the current minimum wages have been reduced to the real wage of less than a deduction of 100 since December of last year. And that's the real value of 537 in Metro Manila is just 437. And this is not really enough to put up with the pricing increase of prices and commodities, especially with the unstoppable increases of oil and petroleum products. And this is happening every week, Karen. Every Tuesday, it's increasing, but then the wages of workers are stuck.